Members of the Buganda Parliamentary Caucus held a meeting today at Parliament and deliberated on matters of national and regional importance. High on the agenda was the issue of decentralization, which they believe has been undermined a lot by the government, making local governments less effective to deliver services to the people at grassroots level. The caucus has taken a decision to push for reforms to revamp decentralization and devolution of powers for better service delivery.
We have advocated for, we want meaningful devolution of power. In the constitution we have a regional government, but a constitution is a living document. Any article provision that cannot be implemented and operationalized, a constitution is not a limbo. So the regional government adopted has been there for now 15 years, none implemented. So we are saying that cannot work, but we are going to devise ways of fostering a constitutional framework where there is meaningful devolution of power and resources.
Chaired by the Butambala County MP, Muhammad Mwanga Chivumbi, the team wants local governments to have statutory share from the national resource envelope clearly stipulated by the constitution, instead of surviving on discretion of the government. In the current financial year, local governments were allotted merely 8% of the 48.1 trillion shillings national budget, despite being at the front line of service delivery.
That are supposed to support, to go for local government as statutory by a percentage. Out of 100%, would say 30% of the money or 40% go to local government. So whatever collections we do, that percentage statutory must go to local government.
Still, the Buganda caucus has renewed demands for equitable distribution of parish development model funds, saying the government should use statistics of population density rather than giving parishes equal funds. They believe this has disadvantaged parishes in the central region that are densely populated compared to other regions.
We have addressed inequality in resource distribution, especially when you flag off the parish development model. You realize that in the parish development model, central region is going to receive the least amount of money despite having the largest population, simply because our parishes are few, our sub-counties are too big, and we have a huge population. Regions with a relatively smaller number of people are going to get huge amounts of billions of shillings.
The caucus that brings together over 100 legislators has also started advocacy for royalties from all minerals mined in Buganda region. Lawmakers believe areas that host mining deposits and fishing sites have not benefited from proceeds of the minerals.
Royalty on natural resources that are in any region in the country, particularly in the central region. We will not speak for Karamoja, but we believe it is high time Karamoja got royalties on the minerals that are in Karamoja. So are the people of Mubende. I think where gold is being mined, and with all due respect, the districts around that area should benefit.
The chairman has been talking about the royalty, but when you find in Bunyoro that people have an arrangement with government, and because of the oil that is being extracted from the Albertine Graben, Bunyoro has got better roads and the incomes of those people is rising. The land is expensive because it has attracted a lot of value. How comes that we don't have royalty?
Buganda being one of the areas infested with land conflicts, lawmakers have urged the government to extend use of Uganda Land Fund to buy interests of Milo land owners in areas with high cases of conflicts between landlords and squatters.
Our Bibanja holders should be told to fork from their pockets to buy for themselves Bibanja, when in other regions this government is shouldering the burden of getting them land titles. We saw just recently when the president went with over 4,000 land titles to be given to 4,000 families. In Bunyoro region, they are also having Bibanja who are sitting on people's land, which is titled. Why should our people also not benefit from the land fund?
The regional body is now organizing for a conference of regional leaders to discuss the future of the region. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.